Hello and welcome class 7 students. Today also we will continue with the formula chapter exercise 13. Previously in many videos I have taught many of the psalms, different types of psalms, variety of psalms are given in exercise 13 which are related to this formula a plus b whole square and a minus b whole square. Today also very few selective psalms I have selected for you, I have chosen for you to be solved. Among those today I will start solving with sum number 38. As you can see, I have written sum number 38 from exercise 13. Now this sum I will solve today at first. Variety of sums are there given and where you have to apply the formula of a plus b whole square and a minus b whole square. So a variety of sums are given. Among those selective sums we will do today in this video. Now in sum number 38 it is given that if x minus y equals to 6 and x into y equals to 16, find the value of x plus y whole square. Find the value of x plus y, not whole square. So it is given that x minus y, the value of x minus y and the value of xy is given to you. And you are asked to find out the value of x plus y. Previously I have taught you the formula of a plus b whole square can be written as a square plus 2ab plus b square. Also a plus b equals, this was one formula which was written, a square plus 2ab plus b square. Again the formula can also be written in a different form, that is a plus b whole square is equal to a minus b whole square plus 4ab. This was the another form of the previous formula. So a plus b whole square can be written in these two forms or in any of the two forms. A plus b whole square formula can be written in any of the two forms used over here. But in this sum, we will apply the second one, the second formation of a plus b whole square. Why? Because here we have to find out the value of a plus b. So here in this sum, a plus b is not given. In place of a plus b, x plus y is given to you. You have to consider x as a, that is the first term, and y as b, that is the second term. So you need to find out the value of x plus y. How will you find out the value of x plus y? Simply by applying this formula. How will you apply? Now we all know that x plus y whole square is equal to x minus y whole square plus 4xy. Now we will replace x minus y with 6. So 6 whole square plus 6 whole square plus 4 into 16. So ultimately we are getting 36 plus 64. 36 plus 64. Now 36 plus 64 means 36 plus 64 gives you 100. So you will write 100 over here. So x plus y whole square equals to 100 that you have derived. But you have to find out the value of x plus y only without the square. That means you have to remove the square from here. So removing the square will bring square root in the right hand side. Removing the square will give you square root in the right hand side. Square root of 100 and that is 10. So the value of x plus y is 10. In this way we will solve the sum. I hope you are getting the sums. Now we will solve the second sum. The second sum given is sum number 39. 38 we have solved. Now we are going to solve sum number 39. In sum number 39 it is given that x plus y equals to 10. The value of x plus y is given to you as 10. Just the reverse formula, just the other formula we have to use. And also xy is given as 9. The value of xy is given as 9. Naturally, you have to find out the value of x minus y. This value you need to find out. Now, what formula we will use? We will use the formula of a minus b whole square. A minus b whole square, that is x minus y whole square. Now, x minus y whole square is equal to what? X plus y whole square minus 4xy. This was the formula. x plus y whole square minus 4xy. So this formula we will apply and find out the value of x minus y whole square first, and then we will find out the value of x minus y. So x minus y is equal to whole square is equal to x plus y. In place of x plus y we will write 10. So 10 square minus 4 into 9. Now 10 square is 100 minus 36. So x minus y whole square value we are getting as 100 minus 36. That is x minus y whole square we are getting the value 64. But we have to find the value of x minus y, so we have removed the square. So root over of 64 will be the answer, and which is 8. So in this way we are going to solve the sum. I hope you are getting the sums properly. Now we will do the next sum. The next sum is sum number 14. Let's solve sum number 14. 40. Let's see what is given in sum number 40. In sum number 40 it is given that if x equals to 2, find the value of 4x square plus 4x plus 1. 4x square plus 4x plus 1. This is given to you. You have to find out the value. Evaluate this. If x equals to 2, it is given to you as x equals to 2. The numerical value of the variable x is given to you. You have to solve this. Now we can see here the formula of a plus b whole square has already been applied. That means a square plus 2ab plus b square is already given. This you have to express as the sum of the square of two terms. Square of the sum of two terms. So 4x square is 2x whole square plus 2 into 2x into 1 plus 1 whole square. So we can easily see how a square plus 2 into a into b plus b square is applied over here. Actually, what we need to do is we need to express this as the square of two terms. We have to express this as a square of two terms. That means we have to write this as a plus b whole square. In the form of a plus b whole square, we have to do it, solve it like a plus b whole square. So we have to bring it in that form, in the form of a plus b whole square. So if this is a square and this is b square, then the formula is 2x plus 1 whole square. 2x plus 1 whole square. Now we will write that putting the value of x equals to 2. We will write putting the value of x equals to 2. We get 2x plus 1 is given. So 2 into 2 plus 1 whole square. That means 4 plus 1 whole square, which means 5 square, which is 25. So 25 is the answer of this sum. I hope you are getting the sums. So in this way you will solve sum number 38, 39 and 40 from the exercise 13 the way I have solved it. So wait till my next video.